Coca-Cola is Coca-Cola, whether you buy it in Penang or Peking or Panama, Panama City, it is the same. And nobody is satisfied if you give them something else which claims to taste like Coca-Cola. Government of India banned Coca-Cola in 1978 and promoted indigenous colas. One of them, in fact, tasted remarkably like Coca-Cola. Nobody drank. They wanted the real stuff. Many people began to, instead of bringing duty-free whiskey, they began to bring in Coca-Cola in India. But Coca-Cola is Coca-Cola. Hamburger is hamburger. Whether you buy it in Tokyo or London. These are hard exports. Levi's jeans are Levi's jeans. Calvin Klein is Calvin Klein. But there are soft exports too. And we have made something out of it. Chili, which is so central to the food of in Malaysia or Thailand and India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. Chili is not indigenous to any of these countries. It was not there before the 17th century. It was brought here. In India it was brought by the Portuguese, and here also I presume it was brought by the Portuguese. It came from Latin America. Today Chile is more known by its association with these Asian countries than with its association with Mexico. That's a soft export. We have made something out of chili, which the Mexicans didn't know much about, I guess. Or even if they know, not the variety of things we'll be able to. Potato is a new world food. But, you know, once I tried to calculate from available cookery books in India, what kind of varieties of cooking potatoes are there. A quick survey of something like 10 or 12 cookbooks. Some of them standing in bookstore, I would just count the number of potato preparations. They came to over 200 kinds of preparations of potato. I defy you to produce that much variety in Latin America. So you have made something of. Cinema might have been an American invention, but Akira Kurosawa and Satyajit Ray might have made something of. These are soft exports. Novel may have come from the West, but we have made something out of it. These are not red. No, this is not. I think we have to keep our minds open to this kind of soft exports, because these exports take place amongst ourselves also. Onions came to India from circulation. And idli, the ultimate marker of Tamil cuisine, went from Indonesia to India. So there have been changes, exchanges amongst ourselves. We have not been swept away by it. A culture which is swept away just because you expose it to a few television channels or beauty shows and collapses is not worth preserving. We claim our cultures to be very old and very resilient. But we should also behave as if our cultures are resilient. We should have the confidence that it will survive these onslaughts, this transient, if you like to call it, distortions maybe. So that's the second point I want to make, that we should be more open to the soft exports.